I've been fortunate enough to have, you know, a lot of special things happen to me in my career, and I think one of them was my debut. It was round 10. It was a Saturday night in Parks, of all places, against the Adelaide Rams, of all teams. This was a good one, this one. And I remember the lead up to it. I remember the night Brian Smith picked me in the side. Kickoff came and I was on the bench. It was raining. It was a terrible night for rugby league. And it reminded me of being back home playing on Robertson Showground. You know, the rain and the field wasn't in the best nick. Finally got the tap on the shoulder. Heine, you're on. Just didn't try and do too much. Hit a few short balls nice and early, which I held on to, and the confidence grew from there until Alan Cann ran over the top of me, and we went over the game. I think it was about 10-2, and it was a night to remember, and I suppose a night that pretty much started a career for me. Another one that sticks out in my mind, and it's the 98 semi-final versus the Bulldogs. I was young in that side. I'd taken Jason Smith's spot in the starting side. Brian Smith was using Jason Smith to come off the bench then. It was a game we all thought we'd had wrapped up. Silver scored a few tries, and then Darryl Halligan had to kick from the sideline to level the game. When the game was level and the full-time siren went, you could sense there was a bit of panic. Well, there was panic from me, you know, and my thoughts were correct. You could sense the change, you know, the talk from us had dropped a lot. One that got away and one that still gets talked about, not just by me, but by a lot of fans and by a lot of media when every time we seem to play the Dogs in a game. Here's another one that, you know, sticks out in my mind a lot. It was the first time I'd ever got to pull on the green and gold. It was in the 2000 World Cup. I'd been picked as what we call emus, and emus are pretty much either the young guys who are just going over for a bit of experience to play against the lesser sides. I'd been playing some decent football during the games I'd been allowed to play. From that, Chris Anderson, our coach over there, decided he'd play me in the final, which was a massive surprise. Never saw it coming at all. The game was a topsy-turvy one early on. I think Tony Carroll, the New Zealander, scored a try for him. I remember Trent Barrett scoring would have been about a 60-metre try, I think it was, and I snuck over for one myself, which was a great feeling. My first try in a proper game for Australia, and the pats on the head. I look back and see the players in the team, you know, Brad Fittler, Gordon Tallis, Wendell Saylor, Brett Camorley, you know, I could keep naming them, Darren Britt. It was a team of players that I was in awe of. I was excited to be in the side. It was the first time I'd been able to hold a winning trophy of some description, and just that whole tour, but especially that game is a standout for me. This is a very special one for me. It happened not long ago, but it was a semi-final against the Bulldogs in 2009. And the first thing I remember running out there was the crowd. I can see very clearly how they would just split the sides, you know, a very distinctive defined line of Bulldog supporters, Eel supporters. One side was blue, you could tell the other side was yellow, and just the noise they made when both sides ran out. That just started off, you know, a great night for the Eels. We had a bit of luck on our side. They lost Luke Patton early, but I think the thing that stands out the most was the Daniel Mortimer try. I just thought that was a great indication of what we'd been or who we were as a side. You know, but the feeling after that game was that we were unstoppable. I suppose in my privileged career, this will have to be number one, and it goes all the way back to my first Origin game, my Origin debut at Lang Park. It was game one, 2001. Growing up watching Origin, I thought I knew what I was going to be in for. I just thought, you know, I can do this. I thought I was the big time, but I quickly learnt that, you know, playing against players like Darren Lockyer and Gordon Tallis and Shane Webke, you quickly get brought back down to earth, and I was brought back down with a thud. I remember running out there, you know, Lang Park. It's everything they say it was. The thing that's fresh in my mind that game was the Carl Webb try. It showed just sheer strength, and the players he got rid of, Jason Croker, for one, you know, who I believe, when I played against, was one of the, you know, physically strongest, you know, blokes I've ever played with. He just got rid of him like a rag doll. And I wanted to have such a great game, but I let myself down. Yes, it didn't go the way I wanted it to go, but to pull on the sky blue jersey for the first time was a dream come true for me.
A wonderful career.